What is going on, people of the broad podcast world? It is I, the Warlock 1ST, with a very special edition of my channel Do News. I'm sorry for that sniffle. I think I'm feeling a bit, I don't know, I wasn't gonna say ill, but no, I just got the sniffles. On today's podcast, I'm going to be making this video to give some advice to a friend of mine. He was having some trouble, feeling a bit angry and struggling with the dark side. I won't go into too much detail. I won't give names because, you know, personal information. I'm not going to do that. But basically what happened was, I guess there was some problem at his work where they had a Christmas party and they were doing a Secret Santa thing and everyone gave everyone something and he felt left out. Because he didn't get anything, even though his name was not, he put his name on the list. And he actually gave someone something, too. And besides that, there was some other stuff, too. But again, personal reasons, I'm not going to talk about everything else. So he said he's been feeling quite angry. Been feeling like the dark side has been consuming him. Wanting revenge and whatnot. And I told him, revenge is a dirty, dirty thing. It's something you don't want to look into. Once you go down that path of revenge, that road of darkness, forever will it dominate you, make you your slave. The darkness is not a road you want to go down. Let me tell you that right now. You just gotta, you know, my best advice I can tell you is you gotta keep your head up, and you just keep going, you keep moving forward. Don't let those negative people tell you what to do. Let's just say, but yeah, that's my advice for you. Just don't give up. You know, don't follow that dark path. Follow a brighter path, the light path. You're better than that. You got this, man. You people out there too are having the same problem. If you ever feel like you're angry, darkness in your heart, or you just want to get revenge, don't do it. It's not nice. The dark side can consume you. It's like my father always told me. If you go on a path of revenge, you're not going to like it. It's going to take you down a darker path. A path you'll regret in the end. It's a horrible path. Anywho, I'm going to leave us to a short commercial break. Let's enjoy a little Christmas song and a happier note. And I'll see you guys when it's done. Bye.
Where's the bus at?
It's probably 10 minutes out.
Yeah,
I guess.
Hey, why don't you sing a little bit of that song we were working on the other day? A Christmas song.
Oh, I'll Be Home for Christmas?
Yeah. Yeah.
You want to?
Love to. All right. It's a good one.
I'll be home for Christmas. You can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents under the tree. Christmas Eve will find me where the love light gleams. I'll be home for Christmas if only. I'm dreaming tonight.
need of a place I love even more than I usually do.
Usually do.
And although I know it's a long road back, I promise you I'll be home for Christmas. You can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents under the tree. Christmas Eve will find me where the love light gleams. I'll be home for Christmas if only in my dreams.
All right, guys, let's give a round of applause to that of Rascal Flatts for their cover of I'll Be Home for Christmas. Seriously, guys, they did a great... They did a great job. I love that song. Deep meaning behind that. If you watched my last... I think it was the last episode or the first episode. I believe I talked about why the song was, you know... It's got some deep meaning behind it. I've been told the story of how my great-grandma would always play that song, you know, in hopes that her husband would come back. Yeah. So that song always gets... It always gets my aunt... It always gets my great-aunt, but it always gets my aunt tealed up. What am I gonna talk about now? Like I said, our last discussion was with, you know, again, you know, the dark side and giving in to the anger and revenge. I've been there, done that, to where times where I just want to say, fuck it, and just, like, wife. There are times when I felt mad, angry, and at first I wanted to, you know, get revenge on some people, but I've had my friends and family to... You know, help me, you know, get through it. Like, my second ex, with the damage, then she did a lot of damage to me. There were times I was pissed, or I wanted to get revenge, or do something, but thank God I had my family and friends, you know, cheer me up. And I'm happy for them. Yeah, my best advice for that would be, you know, don't, keep your head up, try and steer clear of, you know, the dark path, steer clear from anger and revenge, find something to, you know, make you happy, talk to friends, let them give you advice, listen to music, and I don't mean, like, the music to make you depressed, because I know I've been there, no, music as in, the kind of music you listen to make you happy. Play games, write stories, draw, whatever you gotta do to make yourself happy, do it. Hang, if you have to, walk, drive to your friends, go visit them. I always like, you know, writing stories or drawing. Playing video games, too, that can always calm me down. But, yeah, I hope my one friend listens to this video, because, you know, this could really help him out. What's another topic? But yeah, I'm sorry that when I post this on Facebook, I apologize that no, not Facebook, YouTube, but oh, I think I'm gonna post this on the wrong channel. Yeah, I think I am. Oh well. Well, anywho, guys, I'm gonna wrap up this podcast because I didn't really fully plan for it. So, let me scoot my chair in. So, the usual, you know, I'm the Supreme Warlock with Herb Warlock, and, you know, don't forget to like this podcast, like my videos, subscribe to both my channels if you want, subscribe to both my channels if you're new, share this video with your friends, share my podcast around. I'll be probably making a podcast every other weekend, probably, you know, Friday, Saturday, and, you know, the usual, I'm Brandon the Warlock, and I'm signing out. Peace.